Alright, Shalom, please be Brother Hayah, Shalom from the defenders of the gospel of Israel Campus Champaign, Illinois. First off, I want to give all praises to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shah, Rakat Yahweh, Rakat Yahweh Shah. Give honors to the apostles of Elders of Great Millstone. Salutation to the Akim Rahu, preaching the truth for our sincerity. Peace and blessings to the 1/3 member in the church and following law, statutes, and commandments. Peace and blessings to the Israelite foreigners scattered on all four corners of the earth with confusion of faces, speaking in different tongues. Basically, you know what I'm saying? I want to do just a little quick sit down about how America is spiritually Sodom and Sodom and Egypt, and also spiritually Babylon, you know. Because Babylon goes back to the root word of land confusion. And America, you know what I'm saying, is the land of confusion. You know what I'm saying? You got men wanting to be women, women wanting to be men, transgenderism, homosexuality. You know, it's a whole lot of confusion. You know what I'm saying, in this land. And that's why the Lord is going to destroy you. This is the book of Revelation, chapter 11, verse 8. And their bodies lay, I mean, and their bodies shall lie in the street of the great city, which is spiritually called Sodom and Egypt, where also our Lord was crucified. You know what I'm saying? And this is the land our Lord called Sodom and Egypt. You know what I'm saying? Because what happened in Sodom, Sodom and Gomorrah. You know what I'm saying? That's the land where, there was a whole bunch of homosexuality and lesbianism. And that was a homosexuality and adulterous land, you know. And the Lord destroyed that land with fire and brimstone. This is also spiritual Egypt, you know, because this is the land that the Israelites were in captivity in. And for a precept for the land of Egypt, you can go to Deuteronomy 28:16. This is the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28, verse 68. And Yahweh shall bring thee into Egypt again with ships, you know, because the word Egypt means bondage, you know what I'm saying? And for the ones who try to say that we was born back into you know what I'm saying, the land Egypt, you know what I'm saying, which is incorrect, because from Egypt to Israel, that's walking distance, you know what I'm saying. And said that we should enter Egypt again with ships, you know what I'm saying. So we would enter slavery again with ships. And the only time that we enter slavery, only time has been recorded in history that any nation has been entering slavery was during the transatlantic slave trade. By the way whereof I speak unto thee, thou shalt see it no more again. There you shall be sold unto your enemies for bond men and bond women, and no man shall buy you, meaning no man shall save us. And the only time this happened was during the transatlantic slave trade, when we got to the shores. You know, and they had us in slave blocks at slave auctions, selling the men, women, and the children. You know, separating the families. You know, sending a child to Mississippi and send the parents to Virginia. Or, you know what I'm saying? There was separating and selling our families, and no man shall buy this. You know what I'm saying? Buy just means sell. and no man and nobody has come to save us. You know what I'm saying? Every so-called leader that we had was executed. Then why? Because the Most High set it out for them not to be to be our savior. Yahweh Shah Mashiach is our savior, who the Lord called Jesus Christ. He's the one that's coming to save us. You know? But that's a precept on how, you know what I'm saying, this land America is Babylon. You know what I'm saying? Spiritually, Babylon is the Sodom of Egypt. And so this is the book of Revelation chapter 17, verse 5. And upon her forehead was a name written, Mystery, Babylon the Great, Mother of Harlots and Abominations of the Earth. You know what I'm saying? And this is spiritually Babylon the Great, because of all the iniquities that, like, this is the most wicked society ever in history. You know what I'm saying? This is Babylon, Rome, Greece, Egypt, Sodom, all put together. You know what I'm saying? And I saw the woman drunken with the blood of the saints and the blood of the martyrs of Yahweh. And when I saw her, I wondered with great admiration. You know what I'm saying? So this great city, you know what I'm saying, America, you know what I'm saying, is drunken with the blood of the saints, of the Israelites. You know what I'm saying? This land has, you know what I'm saying, nothing but blood of the blacks, Hispanics, and Native Indians. You know what I'm saying? Was in the sense on of that descent. You know what I'm saying? Because we are considered it, because we are the biblical Israelites. You know? And this all, it was all planned out by Howard, you know what I'm saying, that this would be our last captivity, you know what I'm saying, because right now we're in these last days. You could tell by the prophecies and the things that's going on in the world right now, that, you know what I'm saying, that right now, you know what I'm saying, Esau's kingdom is falling. You know? This is the book of 2nd Ezra, chapter 6, verse. I'm going to start at verse 7. Then I answered and I said, what shall be the parting asunder of the times, or when shall be the end of the first and the beginning of it that followeth? And he said unto me, from Abraham unto Isaac, when Jacob and Esau were born of him, Jacob's hand held first the heel of Esau, for Esau is the end of the world, and Jacob's is the beginning of it that followeth. You know what I'm saying? So basically, you know what I'm saying, when, you know what I'm saying, Esau, when Esau's world falls, then Jacob's world will come up. You know what I'm saying? Esau, you know what I'm saying, is the so-called Caucasian, because I don't like to say white, because you got pale skin, you know what I'm saying, people, you know what I'm saying, who bloodline goes back to our people, you know what I'm saying, so-called white people, you know what I'm saying, just because you have white skin don't mean that you're Caucasian, you know, so that's why I say Caucasian, because Caucasian is cave blood, you know what I'm saying, and once their society, world, you know what I'm saying, their whole agenda goes down, then our society, you know what I'm saying, our rulership, we would be ruling again forever and everlasting. You know what I'm saying? And we'll be ruling under Yahweh Shah, you know what I'm saying? Because the Lord right now is is rising up, you know what I'm saying, the house of David, you know what I'm saying, the warriors, the 144,000 men. So this is the book of Revelation, chapter 12, verse 12. Therefore rejoice, ye heavens, and ye that dwell in them. Woe unto the inhabitants of the earth and of the sea, for the devil is to come down on you, having great wrath, because he knew that he had but a short time. You know what I'm saying? And that's what these goddamn Edomites, you know what I'm saying, they got a short time. You know, so they trying to get their so-called new world order in play. That's why you got the Mark of the Beast, which is the RFID chip, being promoted at a high scale. You know, they starting to World War III is at its peak, you know, which is them trying to take over the Middle East. You know, and what they really don't know is that these other nations is gonna destroy America with these missiles, you know, according to the scriptures. But you know what I'm saying, that's why we gotta keep pushing this truth, you know, and keep edifying the sheep, you know, because time is near, and we're in the time where, you know what I'm saying, great wrath is about to come. You find the scripture, so what do I know? This is the book of 2 Ezra, chapter 15, verse 14. Woe to the world and them that dwelleth therein, for the sword and their destruction draweth nigh, and the one people shall stand up and fight against another, the sword is in their hand. You know what I'm saying? So basically it's talking about race wars, economic wars, you know what I'm saying, and world wars, you know. For there shall be sedition among men, and invading one another. They shall not regard their kings nor princes, and the course of their actions shall stand in their power. A man shall desire to go into the city and shall not be able. You know, and that's what's coming to pass. You know what I'm saying? Martial law. You know, when we gonna wanna go to one side of town or going to another town or another city, and we won't be able to because the FEMA troops, and you're gonna have, you know what I'm saying, foreign troops over here, basically it's gonna be wild, you know what I'm saying, and that's what these goddamn elites is getting ready for, you know, the so-called Illuminati, Luciferians, you know what I'm saying. When the Bible speaks of Lucifer, it's talking about them, you know. But that's the pretty much all I have to get on right now. You know, call law, the hour, you know, shooting the other side. You know, the line is to the parts of the eligibility news, so I text the iPhone on the kitchen is true. But peace on with sincerity and diligence. Peace and blessings to the one that is like men and children. Peace and blessings to Israel farmers. Keep pushing this truth and go to the end. Shalom. So,